CBS had no idea that they could top Off the Wall. And when Michael Jackson said that he wanted to top that, they just sort of said, you know, okay, kid, I mean, whatever you say.
By 1982, no one imagined that 24-year-old Michael Jackson could top the success of his first solo album, Off the Wall. But Michael was eager to prove the world wrong. Epic Records released Michael Jackson's Thriller album in December of that year.
Thriller was a record that just took everybody by surprise.
Audiences went wild over the album. Within a month, Thriller reached gold and then platinum. In February 1983, Jackson's single Billie Jean became the most popular song in the country and around the world.
There were always Billie Jeans, basically women who would write him letters. And there was one in particular who was writing to him and telling him that you know, she was going to kill herself and that he was a father of her child. And Michael was just, you know, horrified by all this.
Michael's ode to Billie Jean was just the beginning.
There were 9 songs on that album. Each one could have been a top 10 hit on its own. 7 of them did become top 10 hits. And the videos created for those songs were groundbreaking.
Michael's most famous video, Thriller, paid tribute to the classic horror films he loved, like The Wolfman and Night of the Living Dead. But the video didn't square with Jackson's religion, which forbids members from delving into the supernatural.
Michael was contacted by Jehovah's Witness officials who said, wait a second, you know, you can't do this. And we're going to kick you out of the religion if this comes out.
Jackson tried to pull the plug on Thriller, but record company executives didn't want to dump the costly 20-minute film.
Michael's attorney said, listen, you know, Bela Lugosi was a Catholic, and his whole thing as Dracula was make-believe, and it was part of just having fun. I think that we could put something at the beginning of a Thriller, a disclaimer that will say, I don't believe in the occult. And Michael accepted that.
When this man broke into Billie Jean, it was absolute pandemonium. People were coming out of their clothes, wigs were going crooked, people were standing on the tables.
And it was the first time we saw the moonwalk, and it was the first time the hat got thrown out, and it was the first time that we saw all of the components of what Michael had been working on to turn himself into sort of this amazing Sinatra, Gene Kelly, Michael Jackson kind of character. And Michael Jackson claimed his place in pop history as the king of pop with his performance of Billie Jean on Motown 25.
Meanwhile, Thriller sold 51 million copies and became the best-selling album of all time. In March 1985, Madame Tussauds Wax Museum in London honored Michael Jackson with a life-size replica. Michael reigned supreme as the king of pop.
On May 16th, 1983, 47 million TV viewers watched Michael unveil his signature dance move.
Nobody had really, at least on television, done anything like that. The way his leg went like this, and, you know, in those short pants and the white socks. The whole thing was so groundbreaking.
The moonwalk was the highlight of Motown's 25th anniversary special and a watershed moment in American pop culture.
Once he did the moonwalk, that just made you forget about everything else.
Everybody felt they had a little bit of peace of Michael because they could moonwalk in their living room.
When somebody mentioned Michael, they automatically started doing that kick that he do in a moonwalk.
Michael owned the pop world in 1983. His album Thriller had just hit number one. When the album's first video, Billie Jean, premiered 2 months earlier, it gave America a look at the new Michael Jackson.
His look was a little bit more manly. It wasn't so teen idol. It was kind of like he was stepping into being a young man.
I think that that's sort of the start, obviously, of the Michael Jackson that we see through the rest of the 80s.
Billie Jean was 4 minutes and 52 seconds of cutting-edge special effects and electrifying dance moves.
You
seeing Michael, he's dancing, he's walking up these little step things, and it's lighting up. You're like, ooh, how'd they do that?
When I watched the video, I was like, his shoes are lighting up. My mother was like, no, the floor is lighting up.
The single stayed at number one for an incredible 7 consecutive weeks and helped Michael say goodbye to his bubblegum image forever.
I have something I want to tell you. I'm not like other guys.
On December 2nd, 1983, the most anticipated video in MTV's short history debuted with a bang. The unveiling of Thriller was an event. MTV's first world premiere video.
It's close to midnight. Something evil's lurking in the dark.
I knew if we did something with substance and content that people would watch, and it had great entertainment value, and if it held you, I knew we'd be okay.
For me, like, Thriller is the quintessential music video in my entire career. In my mind, I've been chasing Thriller.
It was the most ambitious video to date, and with a special making of documentary added in, production cost totaled a whopping $1 million. Michael considered Thriller much more than a video.
I always try to be a pioneer and an innovator in whatever I do, and my dream was to always make, you know, short little films.
Michael Jackson comes along and he takes music videos to the next level. He puts a storyline in it, and not only do you feel like dancing, but you're sort of following along. It's, you know, it's a mini movie.
Thriller was a 14-minute epic with elaborate dance sequences and a horror movie plot.
I think that the video for Thriller really just pushed the whole video scene to this other place, you know, as far as it could go, state-of-the-art, extreme.
Weeks after the Thriller premiere, the album reclaimed the number one spot on the charts. It continues to duke it out with the Eagles' greatest hits for the best-selling album ever, at more than 40 million copies sold and counting.
I wonder who is the winner.
Michael Jackson!
January 16th, 1984 was a very good night for Michael Jackson. TV viewers watched music history unfold as the Glovelin took home 7 American Music Awards, a record yet to be broken.
I'm so deeply touched and deeply honored to receive this wonderful, gosh, this wonderful award.
What he took home was nothing compared to what Michael brought with him, an entourage of 80s pop icons, including Webster's Emmanuel Lewis and Michael's date, Brooke Shields.
I like him very, very much, and I think that he felt comfortable that I was there because he'd come back and he'd sit down with me and he'd say, was that okay? Did I do all right?
Michael even took Emmanuel along for the ride when he won the award for Favorite Male Soul Artist.
An important chemistry in writing song is inspiration, and I'm holding one of my inspirations is Emmanuel Lewis.
All those little things that some people think are eccentric and would be really eccentric if you did them or I did them, you know, for somebody like Michael Jackson, it's what you want, and that's what...
It's hard to believe that 25 years ago, Quincy Jones and I embarked on an album named Thriller. To be able to say that Thriller still holds the record as the biggest-selling album of all time is just mind-blowing. I have you, my fans, throughout the world to thank for this achievement. Though this award tonight honors me for my lifetime achievements, there is still much more to come from Michael Jackson. My passion for music has never stopped, and for those who don't know, I've been in the studio recording Thriller 25th anniversary album with a lot of surprise guests. It's my hope that Thriller continues to live on for each new generation to discover. So thank you, TF1 and NRJ, for this very special award. It means so much to me to be honored by you, and thank you, the fans. I love you from the bottom of my heart. And I hope to see you very soon. I love you. God bless. Work on, because I remember my original approach was, how do you make zombies and monsters dance without it being comical? So I said, we have to do just the right kind of movement, so it doesn't become something that you laugh at, but it just has to be, you know, take it to another level. So I got in a room with Michael Peters, and he and I together kind of imagined how these zombies should move by making faces in the mirror. And I used to come to rehearsal sometime with monster makeup on, and
and I love doing that. So he and I collaborated, and we both choreographed the piece. And I thought I should start, you know, like that kind of thing, going to this kind of jazzy step, you know.
It's awesome, dude.
Kind of gruesome things like that, you know. Not too much ballet or whatever.
Right. It has that stiff movement to it.
Yeah. I knew if we did something with substance and content that people would watch, and it had a great entertainment value, and if it held you, I knew we'd be okay. And that was the idea, you know?
When you made the video, when you were making it, when you finished it, did you realize just what you'd accomplished, that this was going to be this groundbreaking?
When I was in the editing room, I knew I liked it. I enjoyed it. You know, it has to be satisfying for me. And I enjoyed what I had seen when we finished it. So I was happy with it. Never totally satisfied, but I was happy.
What about it would you have changed if you could?
I'm not always happy with certain cuts and angles and the timing and, you know, those sort of things, you know.
Your own worst critic, huh?
Yeah, it has to be just right.
Michael Jackson is back in action with his new album, Thriller. Thriller, Michael's new album featuring his latest hit, Billie Jean, plus his smash single with Paul McCartney, The Girl Is Mine. Michael Jackson's Thriller. The excitement never lets up.
Available at all Sam Goody stores for $6.99 LP, $7.49 tape.